Well, hello and welcome again to Edison Light Globes video. I'm Phil Greenwood, and today I know we've been a long time between videos. This is a very complicated one we're doing at the moment, and also my camera operator here broke his foot on a skateboard. So we've been a little while. We've tried a couple of times. This has technically been difficult, so bear with us. We'll see if this one works. But this is a special video. This is a bit different to what we normally do. This is a video that we're doing in response to our experiment with augmented reality. Now, for the most part, when we describe a product, we create the product in 3D, we build the product, we understand its scale and size, and its surface and its color. And then we set it up in the photographic studio here, and we would photograph the product on a neutral background, usually a dark background. It's isolated on its own with nothing else in the shot. It's designed in a lighting sense to show surface, shape, color, texture, those things. And also on a website, all those products as a catalog all have to end up the same size box. So there's no scale indicated by the images. They are basically just the same shape inside a box, essentially. So despite the fact that within the product descriptions, we put specifications for size, that is width, length, heights, all those things, it seems that a lot of people have a real problem trying to ascertain just how it is that they imagine a product of a particular size in their environment. So what augmented reality does is give you our 3D file for you to put into your room and view it on an iPhone, an Android phone, an iPad or a tablet. Those mobile devices all have an application now which gives you access to augmented reality, a little bit like the way Pokemon Go worked. So what we'll do first is we'll show you the basic system, how it all works. Probably the first thing is we use a common application. We haven't built our own application. We believe that the common application, in this case Augment, is an application that should be used by a number of manufacturers. So therefore, instead of downloading a whole lot of different applications for different manufacturers, you may end up just using Augment. And there should be that there's a lot of different applications or a lot of different suppliers of 3D files that you'll be able to view on that application. So having said that, the first thing we need to do is download the application, Augment. The instructions for that are in the description under the video. Now, what I've also got to do is record the iPhone screen to show you what's happening. Now I'm going to set that up now, and then I'll get back to you when I've finished doing that. Stop. So the first thing we need to do is to click on the little image that we supply, and that'll be in a tab on the product page, or we'll send you a file. But essentially, you click on the file and you end up with this screen that shows you the product in 3D. So you can spin it around, you can have a look underneath, you can go in close, a whole lot of things. The important thing here is there's a little button or a big button that says view in your space. So the first thing you've got to do obviously is push that view in your space. It will open in the Augment app, and it'll ask you to place the item, the 3D item, on a flat surface. It will find a flat surface for you. In this case, it's our table, and we'll push on that, and we'll see pop up really quickly the actual steampunk banker lamp 3D file. Now, what's really handy is I've actually got a real one here that's not turned on. I'll just go and turn it on. There you go. So we've actually got a real steampunk banker lamp and its 3D counterpart. Now you can move these around in what is essentially two dimensions of the three. The third dimension being the distance off the table. You can't actually reset. Once you've put it on the table, that's a fixed axis. But every other dimensional axis, you can change. So we'll see here now the real steampunk banker lamp and its 3D model next to each other, and you'll see it's almost sitting on the table. It's pretty much sitting on that surface, but you'll notice that it shows terrific scale and dimension, oops, but it doesn't show really good surface texture. You'll see the difference there. The real brass and our visualized brass is not anything like the same, but the idea of this system is that it's giving you scale. So there we have it, the first demonstration. So for the next model, what we're going to do is explain how we do other products. Now, the augment and augmented reality, 3D itself, it all seems to be based on three dimensions, however, one dimension fixed. And the one dimension fixed seems to be building up from a surface. So placing objects on a table, placing objects on the floor, all seem to work really well. For us, this light, the desk lamp, perfect. For wall lights and pendants hanging from the ceiling, it took us quite a while to work out how that was going to work, because the 3D modeling seems to work from the ground up. So we came up with our own solution, which is to have a placement piece that will allow you to place like a blank sheet of paper in 3D on the floor, and the lights will appear at their appropriate height above the floor. So with that in mind, or bear that in mind, when we show you our wall light, which we can place on the floor first and then see it hopefully stuck on the wall. Firstly, what you've got to do is you click on the image on our website of the wall light product. That will take you again to the Augment app, and the Augment app will show you a 3D file. I'll just download that file. So it downloads into the app our 3D file. This is the same for all of our 3D files. They need to download first. Once it's downloaded, you'll see a little finger thing, but you'll see you'll be able to move it around. But you can see on this one, the fact that the product has this little yellow label at the bottom. Now that is the placement label. That's what we've called it anyway. So the first, or the next thing we do is we'll click on the view in my space. It will open in the Augment app, and it'll ask you to place this. Now, for a wall light, you want to place this on the floor next to the wall. The next thing you need to do is to turn that around, just spin it with two fingers, and then drag it back and make sure that the place on floor pad is actually placed on the floor. You can see that. Now, we'll just click off anywhere, and we should be able to see on the wall our wall light, and I'll go around this side so you can see it. So this is quite a large wall light, and we'll see if we look there very carefully, we can see that it is stuck to the wall. But what it does do is show us scale and dimension, a little bit of color, rough color, but you can see that again next to an actual example of one of those wall lights. But you can see, for instance, that wall light is placed over a door. Whereas this wall light, look, we could move it, but it probably wouldn't fit over the door. And again, the way we move it around is just drag and drop, or drag that surface. We can move it there. If we want to see this one a little bit higher, we have no way of moving it up and down with our finger. So what we'll do is we'll replace the item. We've got to go back to that product. Ooh, look at that. There it is. We'll replace it, but this time we'll put it onto this little wooden shelf, and that little wooden shelf is a flat surface. It's like a table, and even though it says place on the floor, we can place it right on the corner there. Make sure you line it up. So this is lifting the entire model a little bit off the floor, and when we look up, we'll see that the light is now quite a bit higher. In fact, it's at about the height of our other lamp. And so this gives us a way to adjust the model, the 3D model. We can adjust the 3D model's height by simply using a flat surface against the wall. And that seems to be the only way that we can describe a wall light for the purpose of augmented reality. But it works fine. If you have any problems, let us know. Now, The third product that we want to show you is one that we probably get asked about the most, and the one that's the most difficult to interpret, at least dimensionally, for our customers. And that is a billiard table light. Now, our billiard table lights are designed to be decorative over domestic tables. We do make longer versions, make four light versions, we make bigger plumbing pipe versions, and we've just recently made a very large one. Now, problem is that billiard tables vary in size and scale, and billiard table rooms also vary in scale. This is where 3D modelling will be really useful for a billiard table light. Now, I've got to find the billiard table light. I'll go back to the product page, Louis. It's not showing me the product page, so. No, jeez. There it is. Okay, we click on the image, that is the billiard table product. And what we're going to do is, instead of placing it on the table, which we could do, we're going to place this one on the floor. We're going to see the surface there showing us the floor. We'll spin that around again in a way that suits the table. And we're going to place it, because we know that line there is straight, we're going to place it under the middle of the table, because we want our light to be in the middle of the table. So that's actually sitting underneath the table in the middle. Now, when we look up, what we want to see is a billiard table light hung, if we can, over the table to show us scale of this product or this light over the top of our table. Now, you'll notice that it disappears when I get too far away, but as we move around, we can show just how big that is and what it looks like in the room. Now, it's probably, for a billiard table, this one's probably a little bit high, and so we probably would have a different model that suits more accurately a billiard table specifically. We're again working on these in prototyping, so we will get to that at some point, and we'll also show different shades, different brass colours, various options, but certainly let us know if there's an option you want to see. I'm going to turn that off. So that's essentially a description of how augmented reality is supposed to work, how we can use it to describe our product, and how anybody anywhere with a portable device can use it in their environment to assess one of our products for its scale. I'm waiting for that to finish. I'm hoping it records the screen. But essentially, if there's a product that we have on our website that isn't yet currently exported for augmented reality, certainly let us know. If there's a particular shade that you want on a particular light, let us know. If there's a piece of hardware, even if it's just a glass shade or a lamp holder, any of the component parts that we sell, they exist in three dimensions in our system. So let us know and we'll upload the product. We'll send you a link. We'll put the product link on the product. We'll put the link to the augmented reality file in an email. Whatever it needs, we'll try to help in doing this. So certainly let us know if that's the case. So there is a page or a post on our website that explains this in some technical detail. There are links to the application on our website. I think it's a post called Augmented Reality and Product Visualization, something like that. If you want to download the app, go there. There's links to the app. But in the meantime, if you liked our video, give it the thumbs up, click the link, subscribe. We have had a few subscribers recently, and it's fantastic that people do subscribe, because it encourages more of these videos. If there's anything you want to see in the next video, certainly let us know. But in the meantime, for now, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.